Hello friends, today's topic, communication, holistic education. When we speak of holistic education, diploma or degree, whatever the certificates we have, it comes in the last segment, right? There are so many other things which is coming in the beginning, and communication is the lifeblood of teachers. An LKG, good LKG teacher, very experienced. As the teacher said, A for apple, she remembered that I should teach something about apple to these kids because these days, you know, a lot of chemicals are added in the apple. And she started to explain to the children, you see, you should not remove apples from kitchen, and when mommy is not there, you should not eat it like that. It's poisonous. There'll be a lot of chemicals applied on the skin. So probably you will have to soak it in salt water or wash nicely or else peel the skin, then eat the apple, right? So she was just teaching some values as well and telling them how to be cautious about eating apples which are chemically contaminated. So, you know, this one child was listening to the whole thing, and as this girl, a small girl, 3.5 years or 4 years old, she went home. Mama asked her, what did the teacher teach you today? And, you know, she said, Mama, you have taken to me, admitted me to such a foolish school. The teacher is so foolish. She doesn't know anything. So Mama asked, what happened? Mama, the teacher was telling me about Apple. She was telling that our Apple iPhone should be kept in the refrigerator. It should be taken from refrigerator. It should be washed. It should be soaked in salt water. It should be peeled. Then it should be eaten. The Apple iPhone, right? So the teacher was speaking about Apple, whereas the child, the new-gen child, was just thinking about Apple iPhone, which it is almost conversant with. Always it takes the Apple iPhone. As soon as when you say A for Apple, the Apple iPhone comes to the mind of the child, or the tab, or the iPad. You know, then who is wrong here? Thing is, like, a communication means communication has to reach to the person, receiver, right? Unless it reaches the receiver, that's not a communication at all. Miscommunication, wrong communication, there is no communication happening. The communication that goes from the teacher should reach the student, and it has to respond to the teacher in the same line. Now, if you take A for Apple, if you tell the kids now, new generation kids, they will say A for Apple, B for Bluetooth, C for chatting, D for download, E for email, F for Facebook, G for Google, I for iPhone, J for Java, K for Kingston, L for laptop, M for message, N for Nero, O for Opera, P for Picasso, Q for QuickTime, R for RAM, S for server, T for texting, U for USB, V for Vista, X for XP, and W for Wi-Fi, Z for Zopia. You know, this is the thought pattern they have. They have an entirely different thinking pattern, and they are in a new generation. This is just an example. But then I tell you, most of the things what we communicate, it reaches the students. They might say yes, but they understand from a different perspective, or they get a visualization, entirely different visualization. So effective communication should reach the students, learners, and get a proper visualization. If it is able to create, when you say elephant, elephant should be created. The elephant should be seen. Can you just imagine what I say? Now, don't imagine, don't think of a blue elephant. Did you think of a blue elephant in your mind? Did the blue elephant appear?
Yes, Father.
Yes. If you have thought it, definitely the blue elephant. But what did I say? Please do not see or think of a blue elephant. But you did think. So that is the effect of visualization. Even if you say not, it will happen. So when communication is do not think or do not see, in spite of that, the learner will see, because the words are not as powerful as visualization. So communication needs to create visualization in the minds of the student. So it requires entirely different skill. No, the scenario today, the workplace today, is distinctly different from yesteryears or the previous years. It calls for a different set of skills and different style of teaching. Communication is not just verbal. The verbal communication can be reduced to the maximum 16% of the communication. Why? Because the communication has to produce visualization in the mind of the listener or the learner or the student. But most of our communications are reserved to verbal communication. And sometimes we have some gestures shown. Definitely they understand. But it doesn't create the visual effect. If you say X has scored 96% in our SSLC, that is wrong. And that is a common mistake done by many of the people. But if you go into benchmarked exams, for example, have you heard of IELTS exam? International English Language Testing System. That is a segment. If you say in IELTS Viva or the speaking module, if they ask you what is your score in your degree exams or your nursing exams or your SSLC exams, if you say I have scored 96% in my SSLC or matriculation exams, you will lose a mark, lose a band score. It's a big mistake. If I say I have scored 96%, that's a great mistake in English. Never ever you can use percentage after digit. It becomes doubling. It sounds like percentage means percentage means out of 100, right? So yeah. When you speak of a digit, you cannot say percentage. You have to say percent. You read any books anywhere in the text, nowhere it is mentioned the 96%. It's only 96%. You can say high percentage, low percentage, good percentage, better percentage, anything. statistic, you can say. Without digits, you can use percentage, but with the digits, you have to use only percent, P-E-R-C-E-N-T. Is that clear? It's a major mistake most of us do in normal timings. And you know, we communicate to eternity. Teachers, as teachers, we communicate to eternity, and thousands will learn the wrong things if you make a mistake. And I want to see that all your students come to know the distinction between the English teachers can tell them, this is the difference. When you use a digit, use only percent. Without digits, use percentage. When you write a digit, if you use percentage, it is called doubling. Another thing is, when you, there is a function, you invite the guests, no? Those who are sitting at the, in the front row, they, you invite them to a platform. What is it? No, it's dais. It's dais. It's not dais. It's dais. D-E-I-S is the pronunciation. But most of the times we say dais, and it sounds very, very bad. You know, I've seen many schools when you go there, they say dais. You just look into the dictionary. Phonics is given there. You know what is phonics? Between two lines, they give the phonetics, right? That is the pronunciation. As it is written there, you have to read. Dais. No? Dais. And other thing, you present them, no? As a token of love. What is that? Memento. Not memento. It's memento. Memento. So what is P-O-L-I-C-E? It is place. Police station. T-O-D-A-Y. Today. Like Spoona, police, it is to schwa sound, we call it. Schwa sound, it begins with P-O-T-A-T-O, potato, potato. Again, you have the schwa sound there. Mostly, we make a mistake in schwa sound Indians. P, it is P sound, not po, potato. So, stress is on the second syllable, potato. A-N-O-T-H-E-R, another. It is N, starts with schwa sound. Schwa sound means another. Stress is on N, stress is on N, another. Or also W-O-M-A-N, woman, man. Again, it is schwa sound there. Woman. And the plural is, if you take the dictionary, you can clearly find there the pronunciation given W-I-M-I-N. Women. Women you can use, or women you can use, but not women. So, subtle differences, but makes a lot of difference. And F-O-O-D, food, long vowel sound. Food. Did you have your food? So, short vowel and long vowel sounds. Once you communicate in the proper sound. For example, if you say food, it is like, instead of saying Amma, if you say Ama, it sounds awkward. People may not understand.
This organization desperately
change. Okay, did the teacher communicate? So that's an ad of, you know, whiteboard, an advertisement, but I found it very meaningful. How powerfully we communicate, how energetic we are. The teacher is so energetic and trying to explain, and you know how they catch it. And students are really interested to learn. Just see the response, how fast they responded, right? They were so much involved in the class. The teacher was telling them, the lecturer was telling them, the professor was explaining, the organizers need some change. Immediately they are dropping all the changes. They understood something entirely different. And if you think that what you communicate is going to the students, I tell you, that is known as illusion of competency. This communication, what we mean? We feel we are communicating. You know how they prepare the paddy field for cultivation, plowing and all? You have some idea if you have not seen, right? Plowing. You know, they take a lot of pain to prepare the ground. Can you just without preparing anything in that, just in a ground, put the seeds and get the crop? No, you need to plow. You need to make it soft. You need a lot of work. You have to add water. You have to add manure. Then only you plant the seed, right? So also, a teacher's communication in the classroom, 90% is preparation of the ground, preparation of the heart, mind and soul of the students. The more you prepare the ground, the better results will be. If you just go and start your syllabus, the students will never be able to visualize. The communication will just go as you have seen in this chain or other things. So what we need is most important aspect of our teaching is to prepare the ground for teaching them what we need to teach. Okay? See, when you communicate, these are the aspects which is to be looked into. What are they? 10% of she or he reads. If they read, they just get maximum 10%. If they read with full heart and soul and mind, they can retain only 10%. And you lecture, no, you teach them, right? As I do now. What will remain in your mind? Maximum 20%. If say you are so much interested, 80% of what I speak will be a waste. And 30% of what she or he sees, whatever you write on the blackboard or whiteboard or on the screen, whatever you see, 30% will be retained in the mind. And 70% of what you speak. If the students speak, they retain 70%. 90% of what she or he participates. So your communication should be on all these lines. The students, learners should be able to read. That's a way you make them read, make them hear, make them see, make them speak out, and make them participate. That is the most effective communication. Thank you so much.